Let's talk about how you change this into this.
Staring up at the ceiling, I go blank. Waking up with this feeling that stepped up a rank. Try to make an appealing to never hesitate. Just wanna believe in.
Okay, so first things first, now with regards to driving in New Zealand, you can use your Malaysian license for a maximum of a year, after which you will need to convert to a New Zealand driver's license. Now, the first step that you want to do is go to either an AA center or the VTNZ, which is basically like the equivalent versions of the centers in Malaysia, which I kind of forgot.
JPJ Labodo.
So what it is that you will need to resit a theory test and a practical test, but don't worry, it's fairly straightforward if anything else. Basically, once you do arrive at an AA site, or say for example VTNZ, you do need to fill out an application form. So what it is essentially just outlining your full name, last name, your current driver's status, and so on and so forth, and also the various driver's license classes that you want to convert into. So for example, like myself, because I can only drive cars, so I'm converting from a car license back in Malaysia to a New Zealand car driver's license, basically. Now, besides that, obviously you need to provide copies of your passport as evidence of your identity, and provided you have your eyesight that meets the required standard, and of course, as I mentioned, go through the theory test and the practical test. So the theory test is basically exactly or almost similar to the one that you get in Malaysia, where you sit down in front of a computer and, you know, you have to get at least, if I remember correctly, 15 questions out of 20 questions correct, or was it 18? Somewhere around there, basically. Now, there is an application fee that applies, so all in all, with the registration fees and the theory and the practical tests, that does come down to about $157.70. So it's not cheap, but in saying that as well, the beauty of actually having a driver's license is that you actually no longer need to bring your passport everywhere, because you can use the driver's license as proof of your identity, which is the best part, which is what I use it for anyways. Now, the thing with New Zealand is that with regards to driving here, and especially getting your driver's license here, they do actually have a dedicated app that does teach you all the codes and how to obey laws and all the sort of things that you need to be able to understand and know before you are able to drive. So this includes things like merging onto a highway, merging into a roundabout, parallel parking, and so on and so forth. I definitely recommend you check out the app. You can download and sign up even if you're not planning on converting your license anytime soon, just so that you have an idea of what it actually does. So I'll leave a link down to the app below, but it's basically the Drive New Zealand app that you can find on either the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. Now, the thing with the practical test is that typically when you are converting your license, from in my experience anyways, when I was converting my Malaysian driver's license to a New Zealand driver's license, they actually did not test me on my parking skills, my parallel parking skills. It was pretty much just driving along a stretch of road, and they'll ask you questions like, for example, identify all the hazards around you. So you have to actually, while you're driving, be like, oh, I see some pedestrians walking across the street, so I'm just going to slow down enough to give them access and right of way. Or say, I'm coming up to a traffic signal and I'm going to turn right because I want to go into this lane, so I need to just take it easy and everything like that. So it's pretty easy, pretty straightforward. I hope this is as succinct and apt. I'm trying to make these videos a little bit shorter, you know, just for time and everything like that, but let me know what you think. Go ahead and leave a comment down below, and of course, as usual, don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you want to see more things from me, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.
Sunny afternoon weather, snap your mental camera, turn it up a little louder and it'll all fall.